So in this series of mine, just on deep learning for people who are interested in deep learning, perhaps more specifically for medical personnel, healthcare personnel, people involved in healthcare who want to solve problems in healthcare using deep learning, just making these first these couple of videos just to get behind some of the mathematics. Now I have a short video just on linear algebra, which is very important in deep learning, and this one is just going to be on derivatives. Derivatives. There we go. Now, if it sounds like the world is coming to an end, right outside my office here, they're building a new neuroscience center, and over the last couple of months, it's already, well, it's driving me insane. There we go. So, derivatives, very important. We're going to have this concept in deep learning called backpropagation, and that really depends on derivatives. I want you to relax, though. You don't actually have to do these derivatives. You're going to write a line of code, and the computer is going to do the derivatives for you. You should have some basic concept, and if you haven't done calculus in a long time, this is it. Now, I do have two very large playlists on YouTube, one on linear algebra and one on multivariable calculus, and I'll link them below. If you're really interested, you can have a look at those more than 100 videos, really, if you want to get really deep into the topic. I've got those playlists for you. Let's do a few short minutes just on derivatives. Now, let's imagine an equation. I have y equals x squared, and that's it. Or let's make it plus 4. X squared plus 4. So if we have this, it's going to be something like this. And that's going to be 4. And we have this nice x squared plus 4. Remember, behind the scenes, there's another x here, but it's to the power 0. Anything to the power 0 is just 1, and 4 times 1 is just 4. And remember how derivatives work. You must have had seen derivatives at school. If I have x to the power n, this is just simple. And if I take dy dx, dy dx is one way to write it, or y prime you might have seen, I bring that n forward, and I take 1 away from the exponent. So if this was y is x squared, y prime is going to be, bring that n, which is now 2 forward, that's x, and I'd subtract 1 from it, that means 1, that's 2x. And the same, this is exactly what we have here. Y prime is going to be 2 times x, and if I bring the 0 forward, that's 0 times 4 is 0, and 0 times anything is 0, so if we have a constant, the derivative of a constant is 0, it is gone. Okay. So if I have something like y equals 3x squared plus 2x plus 5, I have that dy dx is going to be equal, bring that forward, 2 times 3 is 6, subtract 1 from that, so there's just 1 left, bring the 1 forward, 2 times 1 is just 2, and there's a 1 there, 1 minus 1 is 0, so there's 0 left at the top, anything to the power of 0 is just 1, so 2 times 1 is just 1, so it's 2x, 6x plus 2 is that derivative. Now, let me just clean the board. Now, that's very simple if I have a single variable, but what if I have two variables? We usually write that as z, and let's have z equals 6x squared plus 4xy plus 3y squared. Now I have two, and how am I going to take a derivative of this? If I look, this will be in three dimensions, and we usually have this as the xy plane, and that's orthogonal to each other, so you can think that's in the corner of the room, and here we have z. So we're going to have that this thing, I can't draw that, but imagine it is just going to be this three-dimensional thing in space. It's not going to look like that, believe you me, but just imagine. Now what we need to do in linear algebra is we're going to, the system has to learn certain values. And it has to learn those values, and the way that it learns it is it writes a multivariable equation like this. Now, some neural networks we're going to write, and they're going to have more than a million parameters, more than a million of these, x, y, z, ABC, there's only 26, but imagine we carry on and there's over a million. So it's going to be this equation of over a million. And it's also going to eventually, you could, if we had access to so many dimensions, imagine a million dimensional space, but it will be some convoluted shape in this multi-dimensional space. And what we really want is the minimum. Where in this, now this is very easy in two dimensions, where is this whole multidimensional thing at its minimum? And then when it's at that minimum, that's the point we're after. All the values of x, y, z, blah, 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 all those millions of parameters, if I had a value for each of them, and so that that whole equation, which is some graph in multidimensional space, is at its lowest point, at its minimum, that is the value that a deep learning network is after. If it gets that, it has the best values to answer the question that we're trying to answer through deep learning. So how do we get a derivative? How do we get to the lowest point? Well, if we just have one-dimensional space, let's have that, we can start at any little point. The derivative, remember, is the tangent point, the point of a straight line that just touches that. In three-dimensional space, it will be a flat plane. Imagine a piece of paper that just that is flat and it just touches wherever the space just in one little point, but that'll be a plane. In four-dimensional space, it'll be a hyperplane. In multi-million dimensional space, it'll be a very convoluted hyperplane. But it touches our graph in one point, and I can use that slope to get to a point here. There's something I can do to get to this point here, and at this point, the slope of that tangent line is going to be zero, and the plane that lies here, that touches just there, is going to have this slope of zero. So in one dimension, as I said here, in this dimensional space, it's easy. I have a slope, and we use the slope to update to get to a new point, which will have its slope, which will have a new point, will have its slope, and we're going to change the slope, change the slope, change the slope, until we get to a slope very close to zero, and then we know we're okay. We know that we are okay. Now, this is easy to see, but imagine a multidimensional space, which we can't fathom in our brains. You don't know where it is. It's like you are in the space and you start walking blindly. Now, imagine blindfolding yourself, and you're in the place where there's a bit of a valley, and you have to get to the bottom of the valley. You know, you can wander around until you go lower, 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 until you get to the bottom of the valley, and that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to be somewhere, and then we're going to start taking steps. Now, remember when we looked just, well, in my video, if you watch that, just on the simple linear algebra for deep learning, you know, if I want to get to this point, and I see this point as a vector, what I could do is walk that way, but I can move this one here, so that's there. So to get to this point, I might as well walk this way and that way. So that will be so many units of x, I'll walk in the x direction, and so many units in the y direction. If I make that walk, I end up in that same place as if I went straight there. And that's what we're going to do here. We're going to walk in the x direction, which points downwards for us. And then we're going to turn 90 degrees and walk in the y direction along the slope that goes down. And if we do those two things combined, we've gone further down. And the more dimensions it is, you'll just have to do this in more one dimension. But what we do is when I walk along the x-axis, I keep y constant. I don't change on the y-axis. And when I change the y-axis, I stay in one spot on the x-axis. I see those two as constants. And that's exactly what we do when we do derivatives. And we write the partial derivatives like this. And I'm just going to take the derivative with respect to x. I'm going to see y as a constant. I'm not changing on my y-axis. I'm just staying straight on the x-axis. That means all the y's here are actually constants. So if I do this derivative, that x I can do, that's going to be 12x by bringing the 2 forward. Now, that is a constant. There's a 1 there. I bring the 1 forward. 1 times 4 is 4. The x disappears because it becomes a 0, and the y is still there because it is a constant. That whole thing is a constant, and the derivative of a constant is 0. It's gone, because remember, there's an x 0 here. If I bring the 0 forward, that's nothing. And that is my derivative of z with respect just to x. And if I do the partial derivative of z with respect to y, I see x as a constant. That means here's a y 0 here, so that's going to disappear. There's a 1 there, so that's going to become 4x, and that's going to become 6y. And that's going to become 6y. And that is, those are partial derivatives, and all you do with partial derivatives, you keep all the others constant. So if there was also w's and v's and a's and b's and whatever in there, you keep them all constant. You only look at the derivative with respect to this. You keep or you keep the other one constant. And eventually you'll get this multidimensional pointing things, and you combine all of them, you do the one, then the other one, as you walk there and there, you walk along this way, then along that way, and in multidimensional space, if you have basis vectors that are all orthogonal, everything is going to lead you in a different direction. But if you combine all of those things, you're at a lower point. And now we've got a new point on this thing. We can take a new slope, do all the same thing again, and eventually we'll be lower. And so we will go until we get lower and lower and lower if we just repeat, we repeatedly do this. And that is why we have these things called derivatives. So together with linear algebra, derivatives are very important. Now, if this was all Greek to you, don't worry about it. If you're interested in it, watch my over 100 videos just on multivariable calculus. It's quite interesting, multivariable calculus, but really you don't need that for where we are going. As if you just have some mild, slight concept of what is happening here, that's all that's required. We don't have to take any derivatives when we design. We just have to understand that that is what the algorithm is doing. It is trying to find a path that lowers the slope so that we can get to this bottom point, and that in any dimensional space is what we are after, because that is going to be the best values that are learned by the deep learning network to give us the most accurate solutions.